Are you excited for your next NeuroTalk? Let me switch that slide, please. Our next neuroencoding specialist for your NeuroTalk is coming to the stage with purpose. And this elite neuroencoding specialist, when you meet her, there's no doubt about how deep her care and love for all of you and all those that she works with and serves truly goes. We're grateful that she's a truly badass chairperson for our event committee. She's an author, a TV host, and her life's mission is to guide all kinds of people to everything they want through health and happiness. Please let her hear you. This is Dr. Michelle Odette Green.
It was February the 26th, 2006, a day etched in my memory with both sunshine and sorrow. I woke up feeling alive. It was a beautiful day. The sun was shining and I felt love radiating throughout my home. I felt so excited to connect with my firstborn child, Joseph. But a sudden phone call would turn my sunshine into sorrow and shatter my world. My firstborn child was gone. That day, the ground beneath me crumbled, and it had me asking, what do I do now? What do I do now? What do I do now? But amid my grief, and as time passed, a fire also ignited in me. My son's life, though short, was a testament to living with purpose. His passing woke me up. It reminded me that life is short. Now, I am not here to dwell on pain, but to underline a universal truth that life demands that we live while we have breath in our bodies. Now, I need you to pray full out. We've been hearing this for the last 2 days. To have breath in our bodies is a gift. So I need you to stand up with me. Come on, stand up. Yes. And I want you to take a deep breath with me. Come on, I want you to take it in. Yes. And breathe it out. Yes. Let's do one more. Take it in. And exhale it out. Yes. That's that goddess. Yes. Yes. Go ahead and have a seat. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. 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 I want you to know that what does not kill you can definitely make you stronger. Les Brown reminded us that life be lifing, and things will happen to you and happen to the people that you care about. But I stand here before you today, I am stronger. I have clarity, I have a reason to thrive, and I have a desire to elevate my life, and not only my life, but the lives of everyone that I touch. My name is Dr. Michelle Odette Green. I am a dual elite neural encoding specialist. Yes, I am a speaker. I am a brain health and happiness trainer and coach. I am an author. I am the TV host of Elevate Your Life Show. And more importantly, I am a mother. I am a grandmother. And I am a wife. And I want you to know that my son, he was such an inspiration to me. We've talked about heroes these last few days. So by a show of hands, who in here has a hero, a mentor, and inspiration? Someone who helps you to be your best self. Someone who has shown you what is possible. Yes, yes, let me see those hands. If you have a hero, a mentor, an inspiration, someone who's brought out the best in you, think about that person right now. Think about that person. And I gotta show my hubby on the screen there. Woo! He is definitely an inspiration to me. Now, I want you to write that person's name down that you thought about. If it was more than one person, write those names down. Yes. All right. Let me show you who are my mentors, who are my heroes, besides four that I want to talk to you about, four extraordinary heroes. My hero and mentor, JM3. Look at him, looking good, looking good. Yes, yes, yes. My beautiful mother, Lily Darden. Yes. My wonderful daughter, my innovative daughter, Kenyelle. All right, give it up for Kenyelle. Dr. Amen, yes. We can't forget about Dr. Amen. All right, there's my other mentor. He gives me the double dose, okay? So I had to put him in there twice. Oh, Oprah Winfrey. Yeah, let me tell you, she is definitely a mentor. I did a marathon just because she did one, okay? So I'm going to make $1 billion just because she did it. My precious son, Joseph, yes, my baby boy. And Les Brown, we can't forget about Les Brown, right? Yes, yes, yes. But before I tell you about my heroes, I want you to know that they inspired me to develop a 7-part clarity framework. When I felt so lost, based on the lives and the lessons of all of my heroes, I developed this framework. And today, I'm only going to talk to you about four of them, though, four that are near and dear to my heart. But before I do that, let me look around the room. Now, I want you to look at the person on the left of you real quick. Yes. And then the right of you. Yes. Okay, that didn't seem to work out right, but it is what it is, right? I see beautiful faces, faces of success, of determination. I see faces who wants it all, as Dominica just said. Yes, yes, yes. And I love the fact that we are here with a shared aspiration. For more, the pursuit of more, to clarify our vision, to ignite our mission, and to accelerate our growth. Now that sounds real good, right? That sounds so, so good. Okay, so in a world of constant change, with information overload, it's so easy for us to get distracted and procrastinate, hesitate, all of those toxic tens, right? And so I want to ask you, have you procrastinated, hesitated, lost your way, lost your path? I see many of you, and I believe that you have built successful businesses. You've coached others to greatness, and you've inspired others. But I want to know, and I do believe within my heart, that a number of you, you have your internal struggles. You procrastinate, you hesitate, you get easily distracted, but I got something for you today. I got something. Let me give it to you. Here it is, my friend. Clarity is the key. Clarity is the compass that will allow you to navigate the day-to-day distractions. Write that down, clarity. At the end of this presentation, I'm going to invite you to actually get the clarity framework. So I'm going to go ahead and jump into it. So the first one is to connect with your core values. My son, Joseph, in his 22 years, which is my first hero, he taught me love. He taught me determination. He taught me passion. He taught me to be courageous, and that's why I get to stand before you today. Yes, yes, yes. And he taught me to do a self-assessment to make sure that my priorities are deeply in line with my core values. And I ask you, are you in alignment with your core values? My core values, they help me navigate the challenges of life. And then that brings me to my second hero. Ooh-wee, I just want to talk about this woman in a few moments. Yes, yes, yes. So the second one is let go of limiting beliefs. You got to let go to grow. And this woman, my mother, my resilient mother, write that word down, resilient. You got to be resilient. My resilient mother, Lily. Oh, what a beautiful woman. At the age of 71, she ran for a city council seat, and she faced defeat. But that didn't stop her. She continued to serve on boards and commissions. And at the age of 81, so let's go back to 71, it was 2011. And in 2021, she was unanimously appointed to a city council seat. And now she's known as Councilwoman Lily Darden. That's her voice, right? And let me tell you, she is still going strong. She has taught me about the power of perseverance. Have some of you buried your dreams because you believed they were unattainable? Because you felt like you were too old or too young or too inexperienced? We know we have a 16-year-old young lady in here. She's not letting age stop her. She doesn't feel that she's inexperienced. She's doing the darn thing. Yes, I said darn thing. That's right. And then my third hero is my precious daughter. And that brings me to my third part. Assess your current realities. Do a personal SWOT analysis on yourself. My daughter, my innovative daughter, she not only assessed her strengths and her weaknesses, she did an honest assessment. And that honest assessment allowed her to mark out a clear path. And she was the first to mark it to bring the only magazine that you need to create your vision board. She was the first. Now, there are many, but she was the first. And so I'm so proud of my baby. She also got the highest award that you can get, the presidential award, right? So I'm so proud of her. That came from me, right? Yes, yes, yes. And then my fourth one is reimagine your future. My daughter Kenyelle not only did an honest self-assessment, and an honest self-assessment is the starting point for a clear path and direction, but she reimagined her future. And she actually launched the Afro Unicorn Foundation. You're probably wondering, what is that? What is that? So this lady that's pictured here with her, her name is April Showers. When you have time, do your homework on her, April Showers. She created the first licensed black character that is in major retail stores like CVS, Target, Walmart, JCPenney's, with over 500 products. And the foundation that my daughter launched on her behalf, it is to train young people to determine and uncover and discover what makes them unique, magical, and divine. And we talked about that through Michael Pope's, what makes you unique? What makes you unique, magical, and divine? And we're coming up on my fourth hero, my husband, my innovative husband. He is the epitome of investing in personal development, and that is number five. Invest in personal development like we're doing here today. Investing in personal development will require time, energy, and money. It's worth it. It's an investment in ourselves and in our future. And then take courageous action. continuing with my husband, I'm so excited to announce that we are building a tiny home resort in the state of Arkansas. Yes, yes, thank you, thank you, thank you. He is the epitome of taking courageous action. He reminds me to believe in more. Believing in more means believing in yourself. And so I want to encourage you to take daily action with courage. Because you know what? When you take courageous action, you're building that muscle, and it can only be built when you use it. So take courageous action on a daily basis. And when you take that courageous action, what does that mean? That means that you are stepping out on faith. And I love this part. And you are having a victory. This is the best way I know how to say it, over fear. No matter how big, how small the step, it is a victory over fear. And then lastly, the truth that I have come to embrace and I want to share with you is that you are capable and worthy of achieving your goals. All of us are inherently capable and worthy of achieving our goals. And I invite you to embrace my 7-part clarity framework. And I'm going to go over it with you right now. And again, you'll have an opportunity to scan the QR code. You don't have to put in your information. It is a download. Please give me your feedback. And it is to connect with your core values. 2, let go of limiting beliefs. 2, assess your current reality. Reimagine your ideal future. Invest in personal development. Take daily action with courage. And I say take bold daily action. And most importantly, remember that you are capable and worthy of achieving greatness. Yes, yes, yes. And in the words of my mentor, JM3, yes, life is exactly what you dare to make it. And fortune favors the bold and the prepared. Yes, yes, yes. And what I want you to do is stand up for me, everyone all around the room. Stand up, stand up, stand up. We heard Kay and Shai talk about the I am. So we're going to do that really, really quick. So on the count of 3, you're going to say, I am. And whatever you put after I am, that's what you are manifesting. So you want to say your name. And then say, I freaking rock. Or say, I'm magnificent. Whatever you choose to say. On the count of 3. 1, 2, 3. I am Dr. Michelle Odette and I freaking rock. Yes! Woo! Thank you!
Hey, give it up. Let's hear it for Dr. Michelle. That was some powerful words. Hey, these neuro talk sessions because it's you, it is your skills advanced, it's your skills on display. These are fellow neuro encoding family, just like each and every one of you.